Hi, welcome to the .NET Core Blazor series. In the previous video, I was implementing the user login functionality. So in this video, I am going to discuss about the user logout functionality in our ASP.NET Blazor WebAssembly project. So as you can see that in the auth repository, I have created the logout method and just go to the implementation here. And I have wrote down some logic here. So I am doing the simple thing here. If move to the user login, as you can see that after the user login, I have set the JWT token in the local storage. So when user click on the logout, I am just removing the authorize token from the local storage and changing the state of the application as a logout. If I go to the implementation here, so I am changing the state of the application. So that's it, and I have just created another result page which will be used. On that, I have to redirect my user click on the logout function logout. So I have just go there in the Blazor server and paste it here. Here I have just created the method on initializations, and in this I am calling the logout auth repository logout method and just navigating to the home page. So one more thing I have to do in the nav menu, and I have to add one thing is the authorize. If user is authorized, mean if you authorize, it will redirect to the logout, and I have to add the link of the logout here, and I have to add one two more not not authorized. So if user is not authorized, just I have redirect into the account register, and the login. As you can hear, it is the login. And here is the register. I have not to do anything in the case of if user is not authorized, when user is not logged in our system. So I have just changed the status. It is as the user can see these register and login. If user is authorized, then the user can see the logout button and just click on this and it will be logged out to the system. So just run the project and see the functionality. So the project runs successfully, and as you can see that an unhandled error has occurred. So just inspect this and move to the console. Unhandled exception occurred. Okay. I have to do something in the cascading attribute. I have unclosed our routes in the cascading authentication state. So So this is the reason the authorized and not authorized, and the authorized are not working. And you can see that it is the manuals which are enclosed in the authorized, which is the home and the fetch data. These two are not enclosed in the, these are not under the unauthorized, not authorized, and the authorized attributes. So these are displaying, and the attributes are many of those are enclosed under in the authorized and not authorized and authorized. So those are not displaying. So here was the issue, and I have added the cascading authentication state in the app app.razor in the Blazor WebAssembly project. So now I think this issue will be resolved now. So I have to do one more thing, and I just create new instance for the web API project. So as you can see that now the WebAssembly project ran successfully, and the login and the register and the login pages endpoints are the links are available right now. If I have clicked on login, it just moved login, and if I have clicked on the register, so if I move to the menu.razor, so I have just add some authorized view, and then in the not authorized view I have added two menus. One is the register and the second one is the login, and in the authorized view I have added the logout. So that's on this condition. Now the user is not authorized. This is the reason these two buttons are available and this menu is hard. So just login with the user. Let's click on login and just see what happened. Password submitted, request, now you can see that user is now authorized, and the login and register menus are hiding now, and the logout menu is displayed. So if the user is authorized, then the logout menu will be displayed, and if user is not authorized, the logout menus register and login menus will be displayed. So I just click on the logout. You can see that the register and login menus are displayed. I have to do one more thing here. I have to just copy this and paste it here and just sync this. So it's taking time, and as you can see that it has redirected user to the because user is unauthorized, and it has redirected user to the main page, showing that if you want to use and enter the system, login or register yourself. So thanks for watching the video, and if you have any question, you can put your question in the comment box.